Hello and thanks for watching Proactive New York. Joining me today is Ellie Owens. She's president and co-founder at E2Gold. Ellie, it's good to meet you. How are you?
Thanks. Good, Christine. Thanks. How are you doing?
I am good. Thanks for asking. Ellie, lots to talk about today. First off, can you start us off with a quick introduction for investors new to the story here?
Sure. So main highlights of E2Gold, we're a fairly new company, 2 years is a 2 years old. We've only been public for a year and a half. We have a large district scale property package in between Hemlo and Timmins. So fantastic world-class mining jurisdictions. And we're starting with our exploration program with a small but important resource on the project, on the property package. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to build a 2 to 3 million ounce gold deposit with room to grow and then move that along to a mining company. So we're not looking to be miners ourselves. And we have a fantastic team to move that forward. I'm a geologist, our CEO and other co-founder are a geologist. We have a very technical team, but our CEO also did run, started and ran another junior company. So we've got a team that's really experienced and has a lot of energy to move this project forward. So those are really the highlights of E2Gold.
Excellent. So what kind of progress have you made on your project so far?
Well, since we got the property about 2 years ago, we've done a really important stepping out drilling program below the resource. So the resource itself is surface down to 150 meters on average. So quite shallow. And what we wanted to do before going and trying to update that resource, we wanted to see if that system could grow a lot bigger, because really in these days, you want something a lot bigger than that 150 meter footprint. So we did a step out drill program, exploratory in nature, in that each of those drill holes were 300 meters apart. So still quite fairly wide spacing, but we were able to demonstrate that that system that hosts the gold does extend 100 to 600 meters below that resource. So that was a 10,000 meter drilling program we did this past year. And so that was a very important step for us. And now what we're trying to do is see, now that we've seen that that growth can extend at depth, can it extend along strike? And so that's our goal for this year.
And you did recently receive an important investment by Kinross Gold Corporation. How did you manage to attract them?
Well, I think, first of all, we are in a fantastic mining jurisdiction, as I said, between Hemlo and Timmins, world-class gold gold mining camps. So it's in a great jurisdiction politically and geologically, but also it's a very large property package. So it's 80 kilometers long, 540 square kilometers, 54,000 hectares. So what that means in context is the Timmins gold mining camp is a 50 kilometer long strike, and they've produced 70 million ounces of gold from that gold mining camp. So our property package is very large. And I suspect that, you know, the footprint there is an important one. We also contain a number of important geologic targets. So we've captured in our property package shear zones, Timiskaming-like sediments, greenstone belt. These are all very classic geologic characteristics for all the gold mining camps in Eastern Canada. So on top of having a large property package, we've captured the right geologic context for gold camps.
So what is the size of the investment from Kinross, and how will you go on to use those funds?
So they technically haven't invested just yet. We're in the middle of that financing right now. They are intending to take a 9.9% stake in the company. And so the number value of that amount actually depends on what we end up raising at the end. And what we're going to be doing with these funds is a very robust surface exploration program on the Hawkins Gold Project, and that will develop drill targets for fall 2022. That will be a 10,000 to 15,000 meter drill program that runs until spring 2023. And then also these funds are going to be used towards a small drilling program on our other property package, the Bandor property package. And so Bandor is a property that is connected to the Hawkins property in that they lie on the same geologic, gold-bearing geologic trend. And so what we're doing at Bandor is really trying to do our first initial foray into the property since we acquired it in the fall. So those proceeds are going to be surface exploration on Hawkins, small drilling program in Bandor, and we should see some really interesting results by fall 2022.
All right. We definitely look forward to following progress here. Ellie, thanks so much.
Thanks, Christine.